two of you with me?
I went out on the warm-up in the short program, and I was thinking about that probably 80% because it was hurting me. But, you know, you, at that point, you just think, I had nothing, no other choice. I had to skate and for myself, and you're not just going to give up like, oh, you know, it's not like sectionals or something.
You know, I have to ask you this. With all that you've been through in the last couple of years, are you starting to wonder whether maybe you're not supposed to be a figure skater?
No, I don't think that that's it.
Good.
I think this.
Good.
I just think that, you know, some people go through their careers and they don't have any things that go wrong, and others like me have had a lot of ups and downs, but you just have to keep believing that there's, you know, reasons for everything, and you just have to kind of keep that faith through the whole thing that, and keep getting up. You know, it's like in the dance when you keep coming 20th and you don't think that you deserve to be there, they have to keep getting up and putting on their smiling faces, go out there and do the dance, even though the people don't understand why they came so low. And it's, in a way, it's kind of paralleled because, you know, I'm not just going to, I have too much ability and I have too much, I've come too far. Like,
and certainly too much desire to quit.
So, but just to finish the story of the, the beastly foot, we, after the short program, we weren't really going to do much with it, just keep icing it, and because, like I said, we thought it was getting better, not worse, and we went out, and I told the press, I said, oh, I'll skate tomorrow, you know, if I can make through 3 minutes of that, I can make it through 4 more tomorrow. Whether it's going to be the performance of my life, I can finish, because, you know, I obviously wanted to, and then I came back from dinner, took my sock off, and it was, you know, it had just, you know, I guess the you know, pressure of putting it in the boot and then, you know, the stress and the competition, everything that was going through my body, it just made it spread faster. And it was now, you know, quite a foot, like a block.
So it was impossible, really, for you to do the long.
And basically, I had no, the doctors, and that evening when I came to the hospital and they said, you know, we got to, you can have a spinal tap or a general anesthetic. And I said, excuse me? I thought I was just having IV, like antibiotics. Like, surgery wasn't really in the plan here. And, like, it's not like it was major surgery, but, you know, they sedated, put me under, but, I was right out, even though it was just sedation. But
Are you on the road to recovery?
Yeah, I feel great. It's just my, you know.
You look great.
So
when I called, I got to tell our audience, when I called to ask you if we could come over to see you, she says, is it going to be without makeup? Well, you are a trooper, and we certainly thank you very much for letting us come to visit you today, and we'll be following you over the next couple of months. And regardless of what the Olympic decision is, I'm sure it's going to work out in your favor. Thanks
I'm sure
again.
Everything will be fine.
I'm sure too.